Good evening. Lovers and fighters, how are you? My name is Molly Nelson, and I'm going to sing you a few songs. I hope you're well. So nice to see all of you. I'm going to start with the international anthem. More music on stage. And a bit of water. mind. So, San Francisco. We meet again. Woo! It's my pleasure to be here, obviously. It's Friday. I just decided. I just feel like it. And I'm holding the microphone, so... I've got a little song about abortions. And how much I love them. When they're free and legal. It's a sexy tune. Your week. It's only Friday, so, but Monday to Friday. Just got to town. See, I didn't get my driver's license my whole life because I was always waiting for self-driving cars. And then now that I see them, I'm like, no, I'm gonna get a driver's license. So I got a driver's license 2 months ago. Thank you. I have a California driver's license now. Just had to say that. So I'm Molly Nilsson. I'm a singer, songwriter, and a driver. And thank you. Meant a lot. Took me many years. Anyway, speaking of the future, so we got self-driving cars. We got gentrification. Ooh. Gentrification is actually just more people, you know, being born. I used to think, oh, there's so much new people moving to the neighborhood. And then I realized that they just were born and they just grew up and they wanted their own place. I don't know. I think here it's a little bit different. Anyway, I got a song about it, of course. It's actually a love song to the future generations.
Oh,
Thank you so much. This is a sweet time for me. I'm having fun. I love Fridays in San Francisco. Are we gonna go to a disco later? Cool. Thanks for taking me out. I'll sing a little song that I can never remember the lyrics to. So I gotta tell you, you can trust me. I am the captain of this ship right now. You can trust me. But if it seems like I'm sort of steering off and it's going a little bit wild, don't worry, I'll get us back. But I'm gonna try out the song that I never know the lyrics to. We'll see. Okay, let's see, what are we gonna do next? I'll do a little love song. No, actually, no, okay, I think We've done a bunch of abortion. So Susan Power. My favorite topics are abortions, death, and power. This next song is my little own anthem about power. It took me a long time to figure out what power was, or rather what absolute power was. You know, there's a Clint Eastwood film called Absolute Power. It's pretty bad. But I was like, that's a great title. I think I can do something better with this. So it took me about a year to figure out what absolute power was, because I was like, I don't think the Pope has absolute power. I think absolute power is something else. And I figured that if we all have a little piece of power, and then all of us together, we have absolute power. And that's why we are so dangerous if we're out of control, you know what I mean? But there's something really beautiful about it as well, because, you know, we feel so powerless, but together we're not, and that's why it feels so good to get together with people, you know, and do things together, because we realize that we can change things in our communities, or, you know, in our cities, or in our countries even. I don't know, you got a little election coming up or something. So, I don't know, I mean, think about this. We're all terrified, I know. I don't know what to say about that more than that. But the important thing is that you vote, please, because it's a dangerous time. And more than anything, we don't want dictatorship. Anyway, so now I'm going to sing a song. Thank you so much. You notice that I'm wearing dollar sign earrings in honor of your culture. I have spent a few months in your land. It's very beautiful. I found a costume shop where I got all my clothes. I got these cool rings and dollar sign earrings. So, speaking of money, tons of it here. In some places. So, I'll sing a little song about it since it's Friday.
Woo! Payday!
Yes. Exactly. Okay, so got a little song dedicated to your boss. Thank you and welcome to the San Francisco Marxist Reading Club tonight. You're like, wait, what is this? Yes, you've come to the right place. Communists, they come early and they stay late. Anyway, I got a little song of admiration from my biggest hero, Rosa Luxemburg, who, thanks, we got three Rosa Luxemburgists here tonight, myself included. It's okay, you can join tomorrow. Whenever I'm depressed about stuff, which happens a lot, for a minute or two, reading the news and just waking up to this world, I think about Rosa. And I think about how, when she was in prison, she found a way to connect with the birds outside her window and still believe in the good of humanity and the future of the world. And it's hard to be Rosa Luxemburg, but still nice to know that she was, is, and will be. I have a little picture of her next to my bed so that every morning I get to think about her. So I wrote a song about her, because she was just obnoxiously talented. think I'll do a little ballad just to rest our eyes from the strobe for a little bit. Love song to the planet. This place, my favorite place. The planet. San Francisco too, but we've got some problems here. Yeah, exactly. Anyway, we're all in this really beautiful place, and it's Friday night in San Francisco. Yes, I decided that now. So I've got a song that's not exactly about this, but I like to say that I co-wrote it with Prince, but he would hate that. He's like spinning in his grave. He's like, that song sucks. I would never write that. But anyway, I like to say that because I just love Prince and I just want to mention his name. So. Anyway, I take full responsibility for the song, so don't worry. Thank you so much. Thank you. I'll sing a little song that's about, oh dear, I don't know. I mean, I know, I'm just wondering how much time I have left because...
Hours.
A lot of time. Okay. I don't know what time it is. I know it's Friday. It's probably like 8 o'clock or something. 9, right? Okay. I don't know if there's a curfew. Anyway, I wrote a song that I'd like to dedicate to Marie Curie. You know? Marie Curie. A lot of shout outs to dead people on stage, I know. You're like, okay. It can also be a song about, I kind of feel like it could be a song about quitting smoking. Or it could be a song about everything after the pandemic. So you can sort of just, but for me it's for Marie Curie. Thank you. I'll do a little sad song. This is my only sad song tonight.
Down, and you and I can still go right around. Oh, right.
Oh, I'm having too much fun. Thank God it's Saturday tomorrow. We can do it all again. Okay, I'm gonna sing a song I'll just dedicate to all of you. Thank you so much for coming here tonight. You're all super cool. I don't know all your names yet, because, you know, I just got here. I'm not so good with names, but I just know that you're all super cool people, and that you're all doing your best to get through this life, this world, and, you know, with your heart, mind, soul intact. And I hope that you have a good year. Hope we all have a good year. And I hope to see you again. I'm going to come back and kick your ass in maybe October. I feel like it's going to be a tough time. Maybe you'll need some encouragement. I don't know. Maybe you'll need some. So I'm going to do, that's the beauty of the duty, you know? Anyway, I'm going to sing a little song that I dedicate to all of you, because I wrote this song a long time ago, and I wrote it with this thing in mind where I sit at home in my bedroom and I write songs. My bedroom is also where I sleep and make music, so I'm a studio musician who sleeps in the studio. I'm not a bedroom musician. Anyway, I do that and I come here, and it's so incredible for me that you are here to receive me, and it makes me so happy, and I hope I give you something back, and that you also know that, you know, you can walk out of here and be like, I can do that, whatever it is you want to do. You can do this or anything. so much. Okay, I'm trying to sing as many songs as possible in the least time. I'll play them twice as fast up to. Okay, I've got a little song that I'd like to dedicate to Cyndi Lauper. I'd like to dedicate this song to Cyndi Lauper. She has this great song. It's called, you've probably heard it, it's called Girls Just Want Human Rights. It's a fantastic tune. I can't believe they played it on the radio in the 80s. They were like, yeah, girls, they want human rights. They had no idea what they were saying, but Cyndi knew what she was saying. She was like, girls just want to have fun. Anyway, you don't need to be a girl to know what that song is about. Everyone can join in on the feeling of that song and the message of that song. Anyway, so I was just so inspired by the genius of that song that I wrote my own little song. It's not as good, but it's pretty good. That's why I saved it to the end.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Okay, I'll sing another song. I'm going to sing a song that I don't have a backtrack for it, so I'm just going to sing on top of the song. But just to prove my point that you could also do this, you just got to write the song. But they lent me this, and this. So if you are inspired, you can go and do this with this. Yeah, it's that easy. You just gotta have ideas. This is an idea I had a long time ago, but I kind of think it's fun, so I'm just gonna do it.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Huge disclaimer on that song. Please live long lives and don't die pulling anyone with you. Okay, I'm gonna sing a last song. This is really, I promise, my last song for tonight. And then we'll celebrate that it's Saturday. This is my favorite song. Thank you so much for coming here tonight. Thanks for watching. It's been a pleasure, it's been an honor, it's been fun. Thank you so much, Airwaves, for playing earlier. We had a wonderful 3-show tour together, and it's been a pleasure with them. And I hope to see you again in the fall. I'm gonna come back and kick some butt. so much. Thank you for coming tonight. Take care of yourselves. Stay strong, stay brave. You're awesome. Love you.